बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलामु अलैकुम। दिस इज़ डॉक्टर शगुफ्ता अंदलीब, प्रोफेसर ऑफ जूलॉजी, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एजुकेशन। आई एम हेयर टू टीच यू द कोर्स जू जोग्राफी एंड पेलियंटोलॉजी। दिस कोर्स इज कम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू मेजर ब्रांचेज ऑफ जूलॉजी। नंबर वन, जू जोग्राफी, विच डील्स विद द स्टडी ऑफ एनिमल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ओवर द प्लैनेट अर्थ। एंड सेकेंडली, पेलियंटोलॉजी, which deals with the study of fossils, and it gives us very important information regarding zoo geography and evolution of animal life. Today we will study the evolutionary history of man, and we will learn that how today's modern man has evolved from its ancestor. Hominins include humans, their relatives, and their ancestors. They emerged during Pleistocene, and Pleistocene is also called as epoch of human life. Pleistocene is divided into further three time periods: lower Pleistocene, middle Pleistocene, and upper Pleistocene. Lower Pleistocene ranges from 2 to 1 million years ago, and Australopithecus and early Homo were the prominent genera in this time period. During middle Pleistocene, Homo erectus and archaic Homo sapiens were prominent, and they existed during 1 million years ago to 130,000 years ago. During upper Pleistocene, modern Homo sapiens evolved about 130,000 to 10,000 years ago. Sahelanthropus tardensis was discovered in Chad in 2002, and it existed about 7 million years ago. It is the oldest known hominid. This map is indicating the fossil excavation sites of hominin in Ethiopia. Hominid diverged into three genera, among which two were major. The first, Australopithecus, the second, Homo, and the third minor genus was Ardipithecus, which existed about 4.4 million years ago, and it was discovered in 1992. These are various species of Australopithecus with their estimated age, and we will learn them one by one later on. Ardipithecus ramidus was originally classified as Australopithecus ramidus in 1994. But on the basis of bearing distinct characteristics, it was decided to reclassify them into a separate genus, Ardipithecus. They were not true biped. They could climb trees in the time of need. They were 1.2 meters tall. Their forelimbs were different from those of their ancestors. They have small cheek teeth with thin enamel. They had large canines, and their arm bones were those of hominid like. This is imaginative picture of Ardipithecus ramidus, and here is the fossilized skull of Ardipithecus ramidus, and you can see small cheek teeth. Australopithecus anamensis were primitively bipedal, and they were possible climbers as well. They were identified in Kenya in 1995. Next species is Australopithecus afarensis. It was ape-like in features. It was biped, but its bowed legs helped them to be successful climber. It was named as Lucy in 1974. Africa is its mainland. It was shorter than A. ramidus. It has small skull with flat nose. You can see the flat nose. This fossil is showing its flat nose. It has large teeth and jaws. This trail of footprints preserved in the volcanic ash is thought to be connected to Australopithecus afarensis by paleoanthropologists. This species was discovered from chart in the area Bahr el Ghazal, and after that it was named as Australopithecus Bahr el Ghazali in 1995. It was also assumed to be bipedal. Here is the structure of its jaw, but the incisors are missing in this, and you can see the cheek teeth with cusps, and also they were large sized. Australopithecus africanus was 3.8 to 4.5 feet tall. Its skull was small than that of Homo erectus. It had large jaws. It was herbivorous, and the teeth were also larger than those of modern human. Its tibia were those of ape-like. They have grasping big toes and wide pelvis. They were discovered first time in 1925 from South Africa. This species is known to be the possible direct ancestor to early Homo. They had large molars, they were tool makers, and they were butchers. Paranthropus ethiopicus had large dentition and it had dish-shaped face, as it is very obvious from this figure. It resembles in dental apparatus with afarensis. It was discovered from Ethiopia during 1967 to 1974. Paranthropus boisei was 4.1 to 4.5 feet tall. They were discovered first time in 1959 from Tanzania. They were initially known as Zinjanthropus. They had dish-shaped face. They had parabolic tooth row. They had wide pelvis, and they were biped. Paranthropus robustus was 3.6 to 4.3 feet tall. It was discovered first time in 1938 from South Africa. It has dish-shaped face. It had toes like those of human. It had wide pelvis, and no diastema was there for canine. It was also biped. Homo habilis is known to exist 2.3 to 1.6 million years ago. It was 5 feet tall and erect in posture. It had brain of 612 cc. It is also known as handyman because of being first toolmaker. It had prognathic face like its ancestors with brow ridges. It is known to be probably the carnivorous, and some species are known to be arboreal, and it was discovered first time in 1960s. Homo erectus is known to be inhabitant of different lands, including Africa, Europe, India, China, and Indonesia. It was first time discovered by Eugene Dubois in 1891 from Java. It was initially named as Pithecanthropus erectus and Java man or Peking man. It was found in China as Sinanthropus. It had longer face. Homo erectus were the first hominin who succeeded in migrating out of Africa into Asia and Europe. during their existence time of 1.8 million to 500,000 years ago. They were larger than Homo habilis with larger brain. They were quite social and liked to live in tribes, in caves, and they were used to hunt large animals for feed on. They have less prominent or absent chin, and they were quite expert in making tools and fire. Homo neanderthalensis first time appeared about 200,000 to 30,000 years ago. It was discovered in 1856 in Neander Valley, and after the name of location, it was named as Homo neanderthalensis. It had massive brain, large torso, short limbs, and broad nasal passages. Prognathism in this was reduced only in the mid-facial region. It had prominent and heavy brow ridges and weak chin. This is the imaginative picture of Homo neanderthal. Here you can see the prominent eyebrow ridges. Homo sapiens evolved into two main types, archaic and modern. Archaic evolved about 100,000 to 35,000 years ago. They are also called as Homo sapiens and Homo sapiens neanderthalensis, while modern evolved 35,000 years ago. They are anatomically modern and also known as Homo sapiens sapiens. Cro-Magnon is the earliest Homo sapiens, who evolved about 35 to 17,000 years ago in Western Europe. They have brain of 1600 cc. They were quite skillful, and they had power of thinking and producing art. They know how to make and use the sophisticated tools for particular use. Homo sapiens neanderthalensis were basically cave dwellers, and they know how to develop caves for comfortable living. They like to live in the form of groups, so they were quite social. They know how to hunt to get their food. This is the picture from inside of the cave, showing images of animals painted by archaic Homo sapiens. Modern Homo sapiens is also known as modern day man. It is smaller in size, with 1300 cc brain. It has reduced jaw and rounded skull and chin. Here is the comparative analysis of various skull structure in Australopithecus africanus, Homo erectus, and Homo sapiens. You can see the flattened nose and skull is reduced gradually from Australopithecus africanus into Homo erectus and then finally in Homo sapiens. The jaw size is reduced also from Australopithecus africanus to Homo sapiens, and you can also see the prognathic face. This prognathism is reduced in Homo erectus and then it became absent in Homo sapiens with prominent chin. Brain size is also increased from 440 cc to 1300 cc in Homo sapiens. You can see that brain of New World monkey, great ape, and human, and it is very obvious that it is going to grow gradually from monkey to human. This figure is showing the comparative study of the upper jaw of ape Australopithecus and hominid. You can see the U-shaped upper jaw in chimpanzee is showing its prognathism, and this prognathism is going to reduce from chimpanzees to Australopithecus afarensis and further in human upper jaw. Secondly, you can also observe the size of teeth is also going to be reduced gradually from ape to hominid. This figure is showing the cranial capacity of members of human lineage. You can observe that there is gradual increase in ancestors of human starting from genus Australopithecus and finally its descendant Homo sapiens. During the process of evolution, the brain size increased and the jaw and teeth size reduced gradually from Australopithecus to Homo sapiens. This is comparative analysis of skeleton of apes and hominids. In apes, you can see that the skull is attached posteriorly. The spine is slightly curved and arms are longer than legs and used for walking at the same time. And they have long and narrow pelvis. The femur is angled out. While in hominids, the skull is attached inferiorly. The spine is S-shaped. Arms are shorter than legs and not used for walking. And the pelvis is bowl-shaped and the femur is angled in. This is comparative analysis of the pelvic girdle of Homo and chimpanzee. You can observe that this is bowl-shaped, short and broad in Homo, while it is long and narrow in chimpanzee. This is the summary of the possible pathway of the process of evolution of human from its ancestors. There is gradual change in shape and size of the skull. Prognathism is going to be reduced with every new species and ultimately ended in Homo sapiens. This was the human evolution from its ancestors. Dear students, I hope you have learned. Thank you very much.